Hi, and welcome to the fourth and the final video of our computer vision mini project series, and congratulations on making it to the end. So in this video, we will be combining the returns from all of our previous videos to produce our final output. Let's head right over to the code. So y2, y1 and x2, x1, the region between these is basically my region of interest. We are ascending, right? So sorry about that, it's x1, x2 and y1, y2. We need to ascend from y1 to y2 and x1 to x2, so that needs to be done. Alright, so region of interest extracted, and we have resized our filter, we have checked for frame, we have portioned our filter. So now let's actually combine everything which we have done so far and place the filter on our face. So how do we do that? We are going to be working with a background, which is anything but our filter, the rest of our face. And so I'm going to be using the bitwise and method here. So bitwise and will accept two different inputs, and corresponding pixel values are added with each other, and the result is stored in BG. So I'm going to mask this second input which I have. So the mask which I showed you guys, the black and white mask of our dog filter, is going to be stored under this variable, and this mask is going to be applied on this ROI variable. So now this ROI variable and this mask, masked ROI variable, is going to be added with each other, and the result is going to be stored in background. So basically it's going to darken all the areas, it's going to clear all the areas other than our filter, and it's almost like putting a mask on our filter, right? That black and white mask. So any area that's under black is not going to be visible, but other areas are going to be visible. That is where we'll put our foreground, that is our mask. So again, bitwise and. And in this case, I'm going to be adding the dog filter with each other. And again, mask which I'm going to use here is mask inverse and not mask. Since we need everything, everything but the filter. So since we have our foreground, we have our background, and we have these two variables separately, our filter separately and our face separately, let's just add them into one complete variable, which I'm going to call complete. So that's cv2.add background and foreground. So now we have a combination of our background and foreground added successfully, and it's going to be stored under the complete variable. So let me replace this region of interest, which initially was without a filter, with the complete variable, which is now with a filter. So to do that, let's take this value and let's replace it with complete. So this is a basic assignment operator. So this section can be called as putting the mask on our face. Okay. So okay, we have the mask displayed on our face, but and everything is working perfectly so far. Even the code looks good. Let's check for minute silly mistakes if we have any. Those are very common. They're likely to happen with filter weight. See errors like this. All right, filter width is what we need. So with variable values crossing 10 characters, mistakes like these are bound to happen. So just be careful about that. So let's get out of this for loop which we have, and let's now show our feed. So like I said, our frames are going to be stored in the img variable, and it's under this while loop. So let's show that on the screen using the cv.imshow function. Okay, indentation is really important. cv.imshow. What am I showing? I need it to be filtered feed, and I'm going to be showing img. So now since it's a continuous for loop, it's an infinite for loop, there's no end to it, right? So it has to stop at some point. So let's give that control to the user itself, wherever he presses the enter key. Dot wait key. Okay. So 13 happens to be the code for the enter key. So if we enter, if we press the enter key, it's gonna break out of this loop and it's gonna end the feed, right? So okay, the feed has ended. So now that our feed has ended, we can release will release the feed and turn off the camera and destroy all the windows. Alright, so now that we have written our code and it's finally time to see the output, let us run one last background check and see if there's any problems or any errors. So, okay, make sure you check the parameters and functions which you're going to use, BGR to gray, thresh, binary inverse. So it's very important, if one of these goes wrong, you'll not get the desired output at all. Right, so filter x1, so something I see here is filter y2 being filter y2 plus filter height, so that is not, it should be filter y1. So errors like this is what I'm talking about, and comparisons, filter width is filter x2 minus filter x1, filter height is y2 minus y1. Okay, so hopefully, one second, hopefully no more errors. Yes, there it is. So as you can see, the filter has successfully detected my face and it's all around my face and it works just like any other filter on Instagram and Snapchat. So there it is. I'm going to press the enter key to get out of this loop. So that was it, folks. Thank you so much for listening to me, watching this video, and we have a lot more projects lined up in the series which you're definitely going to enjoy. And make sure you stay tuned by subscribing to our channel and definitely like and comment if there's any problems which you had. So that's gonna be it. Thank you so much.